Hi everyone, once again welcome to my channel Competitive Maths by Balaji. So far we discussed the properties of rational numbers, that is first one is closure property under four operations, second one is commutative property under four operations, and third one associative property under four operations. Let us see fourth property, which is called identity property.
Okay. Fourth property, identity property. First one is that under identity property, additive identity, or we call the role of zero in the set of rational numbers. Yes, what is identity property? The sum of any rational number and a zero. The sum of any rational number and a zero is the rational number itself. Let us see examples. Example, 1 plus 0. What is the sum of 1 and 0? That is 1. Or 0 plus 1 is equal to again 1. That is sum of any rational number and 0. Sum of any rational number and 0 is the rational number itself. That is sum of any rational number and 0 is the rational number itself. Let us see two more examples. Minus 2 plus 0, or 0 plus of minus 2. That is minus 2 plus 0 is again the rational number itself. Sum of 0 and a rational number is again the rational number itself. That is 0 plus minus 2 equal minus 2. Now let us see. 1 by 2 is a rational number plus 0, or 0 plus 1 by 2. Okay. 1 by 2 plus 0. That is sum of any rational number and 0 is the rational number itself. So 1 by 2 plus 0 is 1 by 2. Again, 0 plus 1 by 2 is also 1 by 2. For this reason, 0 is called additive identity for rational numbers. For this reason, we call 0 as identity element of addition, or simply 0 is called additive identity. Okay, so now this can be concluded as, thus for all a rational number a by b is a rational number, we have a by b plus 0, or 0 plus a by b is equal the rational number itself. This property is known as identity property under addition. Identity property under addition. And 0 is called additive identity for rational numbers. Now, we have set of natural numbers and set of whole numbers, set of integers and set of rational numbers. Is additive identity exist for natural numbers? Additive identity is exist for natural number. This is very important thing, as natural number starts with 1, 2, 3 and so on, dash, dash, dash. There is no 0 in natural number set. So that additive identity is not exist for natural numbers, but it is exist for whole numbers, integers and rationals, as 0 is included in all three sets. Okay, right. Next. The role of one or multiplicative identity. The product of any rational number. What is here? The product of any rational number and one. The product of any rational number and one is the rational number itself. Let us see examples. 3 is multiplied by 1. What we get? Or 1 is being multiplied by 3. What we get? Similarly, 2 into 1. are 7/8 into 1. Let us see some examples and consider or are 1 into 2 and 1 into 7/8. That is, product of any rational number and 1, the rational number itself, that is 3 ones are 3 and 1 threes are also 3, 2 ones are 2, 1 twos are 2. Product of any rational number and 1 is the rational number itself. Product of 1 and any rational number is the rational number itself. For this reason, 1 is called multiplicative identity. For this reason, we call 1 as multiplicative identity. Multiplicative identity for rational numbers. Okay. Thus, for all any rational number, A by B is a rational number, we have A by B into 1 or 1 into A by B. Product of rational number and 1. Product of 1 and any rational number is the rational number itself. This property is known as multiplicative identity. This property is known as multiplicative identity. And we call 1 as the multiplicative identity for rational numbers. Let us see for set of natural numbers and set of whole numbers, set of integers and set of rational numbers. Multiplicative identity is exist for natural number? Yes, is exist. As natural number starts from 1, 2, dash, dash, dash. And a whole number starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, dash, dash, dash. Integers are dash, 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 minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, dash, dash, dash. And rational numbers are P by Q form, where Q must be not equal to 0 and P, comma Q are integers. So, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers and rational numbers all are included the element 1. So, multiplicative identity is exist for each and every set of numbers. Next property, inverse property. Let us see inverse property under addition, or it is called additive inverse. Inverse property under addition or additive inverse. Sometimes additive inverse is called negative of a rational number. Additive inverse means negative of a rational number. Let us see what is additive inverse property. If the sum of two rationals is 0, then the rational numbers are called additive inverses of each other. Additive inverses of each other. When we call two rational numbers are additive inverses to each other, if the sum of two rational numbers is 0. Let us see some examples. 3 plus of minus 3. What is the sum of positive 3 and negative 3? Since 3 plus of minus is minus 3. 3 minus 3 is 0. Yes. Sum of 3 and minus 3 is 0. Therefore, 3 comma minus 3 are called additive inverses of each other. That is, additive inverse of 3 is minus 3. Additive inverse of minus 3 is 3. Okay. Similarly, 5 plus of minus 5 is also equal to 0, as positive negative sum is 0. Okay. Right. So, 5 is the additive inverse of minus 5. Minus 5 is the additive inverse of 5. So that if the sum of two rationals is 0, then the rationals are called additive inverses of each other. 2/3 plus question mark equals 0. And question mark plus 2/3 equals 0. Now tell me, what comes in the question mark? What comes in the question mark? When the sum of two numbers is 0, if they are additive inverses to each other. If they are additive inverses to each other. So, minus 2/3 comes at a question mark as negative of 2 by 3 is minus 2 by 3. Sum of these two numbers is 0. Then 2 by 3 comma minus 2 by 3 are called additive inverses to each other. Here also minus 2 by 3. So minus 2 by 3 comes at question mark. That is, in other words, we call that negative of 3 is minus 3. Negative of minus 3 is 3. As their sum is 0, we call negative of 3 is minus 3. And negative of minus 3 is 3. Also, 3 is the additive inverse of minus 3. 3 is the additive inverse of minus 3. Or minus 3 is the additive inverse of 3. Same for the remaining examples also. Okay. This property is known as additive inverse property. Or inverse property under addition. Okay. This can be concluded as, for all rational number a by b belongs to Q, there exist negative of a by b, that is minus a by b, such that sum of these two rationals is equal to 0. That is a by b plus of minus a by b, or minus a by b plus of a by b, both sum equal to 0. Both sum is equal to 0. This property is known as inverse property under addition. Inverse property under addition. And here minus a by b is the negative of a by b. Minus a by b is the negative of a by b. As their sum is 0. We call a by b comma minus a by b are additive inverses to each other. Here we say that a by b comma minus a by b are additive inverses to each other. Additive inverses to each other. Okay. Yes. Now, let us see some examples, questions based on additive inverse property. Write the additive inverses of each of the following rational numbers. We have to write additive inverses of each of the rational numbers. Yes. 4 by 9. Additive inverse of 4 by 9 is equal to negative of 4 by 9, that is minus 4 by 9. Additive inverse of 4 by 9 is negative of 4 by 9, that is minus 4 by 9. And additive inverse of, second question, additive inverse of minus 13 by 7 is, since minus 13 by 7 is a negative number, its additive inverse is negativity of negative, that is minus of minus 13 by 7. Additive inverse of minus 13 by 7 is minus of minus 13 by 7, that is minus of minus plus, or negative of negativity is positive, that is 13 by 7. So additive inverse of minus 13 by 7 is plus 13 by 7. Additive inverse of plus 4 by 9 is minus 4 by 9. Since 5 by minus 11 can be written as minus 5 by 11. Okay. We have 5 by minus 11 means minus 5 by 11. Now, additive inverse of minus 5 by 11 is equal to minus of minus 5 by 11. That is, negativity of negative is positive. 5 by 11 is the additive inverse of minus 5 by 11. Similarly, minus 11 by minus 14. Okay. So, negativity of negative is positive. We have minus 11 by minus 14 means 11 by 14. So, additive inverse of 11 by 14 is equal to negative of 11 by 14. That is minus 11 by 14.
Okay. Next, inverse property under multiplication
or multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse, or it is called reciprocal of a non-zero rational number. Inverse property under multiplication or multiplicative inverse or reciprocal of a non-zero rational number. Let us see what is multiplicative inverse property. If the product of two rational numbers is 1, product of two rational numbers is 1, then the rational numbers are called multiplicative inverses to each other, are called multiplicative inverses to each other. Let us see example. Example. So, consider 2 by 7. By which rational number 2 by 7 is being multiplied to get the product 1? By which rational number 2 by 7 must be multiplied to get their product is 1? Obviously, reciprocal of 2 by 7. That is 7 by 2. Okay. Since 2 by 7 into 7 by 2, which is equal to 7 2s are 14 by 7 2s are 14. 14 by 14, that is 1. Yes. Since 2 by 7 into 7 by 2 equal to 1, then 2 by 7 is the multiplicative inverse of 7 by 2, as well as 7 by 2 is the multiplicative inverse of 2 by 7. Yes, here 2 by 7 multiplicative inverse is 7 by 2. Or 7 by 2 multiplicative inverse is 2 by 7. That is reciprocal of a rational number is called its multiplicative inverse. Right. Next. Example 1, this is, let us see another example. By what rational number 2 must be multiplied to get their product is 1? Or by which rational number 2 must be multiplied to get their product 1? Obviously, reciprocal of 2, that is 1 by 2. Here also, the product of two numbers is 1. Then 1 is a reciprocal of other. As 2 2s are gets cancelled, we get 1 in the RHS. Here also 2 2s are gets cancelled, we get 1. So this property is known as multiplicative inverse, okay, or inverse property under multiplication. This can be concluded as, thus, for all a rational number like A by B, there exists its reciprocal. There exists its reciprocal B by A such that A by B into B by A or B by A into A by B, which is equal to 1. This property is known as inverse property under multiplication, where A by B is multiplicative inverse of B by A. B by A is multiplicative inverse of A by B. In other words, very very important thing is that for a non-zero rational number, for a non-zero rational number, A by B, for a non-zero rational number, that means multiplicative inverse is defined for only non-zero rational numbers, but not defined to zero numbers. Okay? Right. For a non-zero rational numbers A by B, the reciprocal of A by B can be written as A by B whole inverse. A by B whole inverse. Reciprocal of A by B or multiplicative inverse of A by B can be written as A by B whole inverse. What is reciprocal of A by B? That is B by A. So that A by B whole inverse means B by A. A by B whole inverse means B by A. Again, for a non-zero rational number a by b, the reciprocal of a by b is b by a, but it reciprocal of a by b can be written as a by b whole inverse. So that we can make a note, that is a by b whole inverse is equal to reciprocal of a by b or multiplicative inverse of a by b, that is b by a. So this is a formula. Okay, next example, find the multiplicative inverses of the following rationals. First one is 4, second one minus 3 by 2, and third one minus 4 by minus 5. So find the multiplicative inverses of the following. What is the multiplicative inverse of 4? That is reciprocal of 4, that is 1 by 4. So multiplicative inverse of 4 is 1 by 4. Similarly, multiplicative inverse of minus 3 by 2 is MI. MI means multiplicative inverse, is equal to reciprocal of minus 3 by 2, that is 2 by minus 3. But we have 2 by minus 3 means minus 2 by 3. So that is the multiplicative inverse or reciprocal of minus 3 by 2 is minus 2 by 3. Since minus 4 by minus 5 can be written as 4 by 5, as negativity of negative is positive. So now multiplicative inverse or multiplicative inverse of 4 by 5 is equal to reciprocal of 4 by 5, that is 5 by 4. Okay. Question. Next question. Simplify the following. First question, 5 by 13 whole inverse. And second question, 5 by 13 whole inverse, again whole inverse. 5 by 13 whole inverse, again whole inverse. That is, what does it mean? 5 by 13 whole inverse means reciprocal of 5 by 13 or multiplicative inverse of 5 by 13. That is 13 by 5 simply. Okay. What does it mean? 5 by 13 whole inverse means reciprocal of 5 by 13 or multiplicative inverse of 5 by 13. That is 13 by 5. Now, first simplify this part. 5 by 13 whole inverse means 13 by 5. Again, we have whole inverse. Again, consider reciprocal of 13 by 5. That is 5 by 13. As we can write, A by B whole inverse, A by B inverse, whole inverse is written as A by B simply. A by B inverse, whole inverse is equal to A by B. So 5 by 13 inverse, whole inverse is equal to 5 by 13. Okay. Students, this completes the part 5 of rational numbers. Okay, thank you for watching my videos. We will meet again part 6 of rational numbers.